Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is December 3rd, 2013. People, I have something to show you guys, right? You know about this guy that died in the car crash, right? This movie star. Why are they lying? People, I'm about to show you all, right? I'm about to bust this guy in a lie, right? And Piers Morgan, no, he lied, but he let him get away with the lie, like he trying to make him clear something up. Listen to this, people, right? He's gonna lie about the time of the crash. Okay? Listen to this, and I'm gonna show you how where he lie. First, he's gonna say within 2 minutes, then he's gonna change it and say within 20 minutes. Okay, listen.
We had a great big turnout. There are a lot of beautiful cars here, a lot of great people here. Shortly before this accident happened, someone had brought in $850,000 worth of toys, which made Roger and Paul so excited. They were both giddy and happy and everything else because this was a great turnout all the way around.
You saw him leave, I believe, in this Porsche Carrera. It's a 2005 model, obviously a very high-powered car, estimated value about $450,000. When he left, did you have any idea of how long they were going to be out in the car? Were they due to come back in it?
Well, when Roger and Paul drove by us, I was standing by several other cars, a Ford GT and a Ferrari that belongs to a friend of mine, and they said we'll be back in 5 minutes. That was the last thing that we heard from them before the accident happened.
And the first you knew that there had been a terrible accident was what? What did you see or hear?
Well, I heard the car go by us, I heard them go through their gears and then drive, and I said, hey, there goes the Porsche, you know, looks great, everything's nice. And within 2 minutes of having them go by us, I heard a big, terrible, horrible crash noise. At first, I didn't want to believe, and I said, wait a second. I think they were in a car accident. I called my son over, and I said, Brian, I said, get up to the car accident. He goes, what car accident? I said, I think.
Okay, people, you all heard him, right? He said within 2 minutes after they drove past him, okay, he heard the crash. Listen to it again. I'm going to rewind it, let you all hear it. Within 2 minutes. Then you're going to turn around and lie and say 20 minutes. Unless I'm hearing something wrong.
And Roger and Paul drove by us. I was standing by several other cars, a Ford GT and a Ferrari that belongs to a friend of mine, and they said we'll be back in 5 minutes. That was the last thing that we heard from them before the accident happened.
And the first you knew that there had been a terrible accident was what? What did you see or hear?
Well, I heard the car go by us, I heard them go through their gears and then drive, and I said, hey, there goes the Porsche, you know, looks great, everything's nice. And within 2 minutes of having them go by us, I heard a big, terrible, horrible crash.
2 minutes, listen to
At
that.
At first, I didn't want to believe, and I said, wait a second. I think they were in a car accident. I called my son over, and I said, Brian, I said, get up to the car accident. He goes, what car accident? I said, I think Paul and Roger were just in the car accident. He says, why? I said, there's smoke. So he took off. He came up here right away to see what he can do and to see if it was an accident. I was asking other people at the event, some of the employees and stuff as well, to get up and see if there was an accident. Some of Paul's friends came up here not knowing how bad it was. And when they got here, of course, you saw what happened.
We've got some a clip here of Paul Walker's father actually at the scene today, getting very emotional. Let's watch this.
I was proud of him every day. He was always doing stuff for us. Big gestures. He just, his heart was so big.
Made me sad, obviously, for all the family and indeed for his millions of fans around the world. Been a great outpouring of grief for Paul Walker's death. Tell me this, Jim Thorpe. You said they intended to go out for about 5 minutes. How long had they been out when you saw them go past you?
People, you all hear this question again, right? Remember the first time Piers asked them, he said within 2 minutes. Look how Piers Morgan going to get him to clear it up now. People, what's going on here? They're hiding something. Listen to this very carefully.
Made me sad, obviously, for all the family and indeed for his millions of fans around the world. Been a great outpouring of grief for Paul Walker's death. Tell me this, Jim Thorpe. You said they intended to go out for about 5 minutes. How long had they been out when you saw them go past you seconds before the crash?
They were gone. It seemed like 5 minutes, but it was longer. They were gone about 20 minutes.
Bill, did y'all hear that? Y'all heard that, right?
And the first you knew that there had been a terrible accident was what? What did you see or hear?
Well, I heard the car go by us, you know, I heard them go through their gears and then drive, and I said, hey, there goes the Porsche, you know, looks great, everything's nice. And within 2 minutes of having them go by us, I heard a big, terrible, horrible crash noise. At first, I didn't want to believe, and I said, wait a second, I think they were in a car accident. I called my son over, and I said, Brian, I said, get up to the car accident. He goes, what car accident? I said, I think.
Tell me this, Jim Thorpe. You said they intended to go out for about 5 minutes. How long had they been out when you saw them go past you seconds before the crash?
They were gone. It seemed like 5 minutes, but it was longer. They were gone about 20 minutes.
Bill, did y'all hear that? Y'all heard that, right? First time he said 2 minutes. No, he said, oh, it's like 5 minutes, but it was longer than that, about 20 minutes. Why are they lying? What are they hiding? Okay. Something's going on. Be suspicious, people. Okay.
They were gone. It seemed like 5 minutes, but it was longer. They were gone about 20 minutes.
And what were they doing in that
if
time?
That, just to even that.
What were they doing? Were they just testing the car, just playing around with it? What would you describe the activity that they were engaged in?
They were
the
just
car?
Going around the block. They were just driving the car.
And what kind of speeds
taking
out, do you think?
You know, test driving the car.
What kind of speeds?
Well, you know, I never saw them really go fast, so it's kind of hard because when they pulled out of the parking lot, they were going very slow. We had a highway patrolman that was down in the end of the street to stop people from drag racing or doing anything else because this area is known for kids drifting out here. You know, unfortunately, that's just the way it is. There's a lot of kids and their little Toyotas and stuff that come out here and they drift, which they
stop lying, man.
In the middle of the street, which makes it look like they did something wrong, but the tire marks don't compare to the tires on the car.
So from everything that you've seen at the scene, none of those tire marks that we're looking at now could actually have come from the Porsche itself.
That's correct.
And that is because the tires are much wider on the Porsche, is that right?
The tires are much wider on the Porsche than what's on a Honda or a Toyota. These tire marks are 6 to 8 inches wide. The minimum size tire on a Porsche is 12 to 18 inches wide wider.
There's obviously been huge speculation about what may have happened. A lot of speculation focused on whether they were speeding at high speed. Nobody seems to really know. From everything that you have seen and gleaned from the scene there, what would your best guess be about the likely cause of what happened here?
Well, of course, something tragically happened. Not being behind the vehicle, I can't speculate on exactly what it was
clean
or anything
up,
else, and I'm not even going to try to guess because two of our friends have passed in this. And the tragic thing is there's so many speculations about drag racing, doing donuts, doing, you know, drifting around the corner. That never happened. That never happened. Because when they passed me, there were no cars next to them, in front of them, behind them, or on the side of them. They were by themselves. So it was impossible for somebody to make an accusation saying that they were drag racing.
But you make us suspicious by lying, saying, first you're 2 minutes, within 2 minutes, you heard a loud bang. A car, it's not going to be a loud bang unless they're racing, so you're lying. If that was within 2 minutes, they had to have been speeding for you to hear a bang from 2 minutes away in a Porsche. So you're lying. You're giving people reason to be suspicious. Then you come back and say it was 20 minutes. Stop lying. If it was 20 minutes, you not been able to hear the band because they'd have been too far away. So stop lying.